certainly know his work. In a career that spanned five decades, from the 1920s to the 1960s, Mance made a name for himself as a movie pilot who would do stunts no one else could do. He was an innovator of cinematography techniques for a variety of aircraft, including the B-25. Paul was an aerial unit director for the military and on Hollywood movies, such as 12 O'Clock High, For Whom the Bell Tolls, It's a Mad, 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 Mad World, Around the World in 80 Days, and Flight of the Phoenix, the movie in which he lost his life. But Paul Mance achieved a lot more. In 1930, he set a new record for consecutive outside loops. Later, he became the first to recover successfully from a flat spin and went on to train military pilots on spin recovery. In 1933, he flew a formation exhibition at the National Air Races in Los Angeles, where he was so well received that aerobatic performances were added as a regular feature of the air races. Paul tried his hand at air racing as well, winning the famous Bendix Trophy, an unprecedented three times. Mance was a trainer, a mentor, and a benefactor. He was Amelia Earhart's instructor and technical advisor, and he started the world's first advanced acrobatic flying course. Paul also did a large amount of benevolent flying, transporting doctors to critically ill patients, or patients to doctors. In recognition of his many achievements, the ICAS Foundation is pleased to welcome Paul Mance, the king of Hollywood pilots, into the Air Show Hall of Fame.